Dear Heavenly Father, please be with us tonight. Help us to play to the best of our abilities. And everything we do, we pray that we glorify you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
A chance to reach the masses.
This ain't no trip to a foreign land, but you can take a stand in the public school. This ain't no trip to a foreign land, but you can take a stand in the public school. This may not be Mexico, your chance to reach the masses.
This ain't no trip to a foreign land, but you can take a stand in your public school. This ain't no trip to a foreign land, but you can take a stand in your public school. This ain't no trip to a foreign land.
This ain't no trip, this ain't no trip, this ain't no trip.
I'll tell you a little bit about Bob. Bob is very eccentric. Sometimes I'd consider him on the verge of being nuts.
He does write a lot of the lyrics. I mean, the guy can do anything, man. I think he's going to be president or a TV evangelist someday.
It's really his idea, the whole name and everything about Audio Adrenaline.
Bob plays keyboards in our band, and he's probably a musical midget.
We're teaching him as we go how to play keyboard, so he's doing really good for not knowing how to play.
Get off! He also drives truck. He's not a very good driver.
The reason he's a truck driver because he likes to be alone a lot at night so he can think of new lyrics. So he sits in his truck and drives from concert to concert.
Yeah, I think he drives by Braille.
Bob started writing poetry, and every week he would take his new poems and hang them up on the wall in the dorm. And people would come by and read them. It was some of the weirdest stuff I ever read in my whole life.
Write some of the coolest lyrics, I think, in Christian music.
he like adds a whole different perspective to our music.
Sometimes it's amazing that someone in a band that plays keyboards and is a background singer can't do either one.
Hey, that's not very nice.
Just an all-around great guy, very funny guy.
If you didn't know, Bob is quite the Poindexter of our group.
So that's Bob in a nutshell. No pun intended.
If we're gonna talk about people, I'll start with Mark.
He writes great lyrics, and he's a great singer, and a great musician all the way around, a great speaker and front man.
Mark loves country music.
I don't know why.
He's gonna be a great country singer someday, but right now we need him to do rock and roll.
Mark's job is merchandise. He takes care of all the merchandise. He designs all the t-shirts, and he's really good at it, very good at it.
One of the things about Mark that I admire the most is that he's so talented in so many ways.
Mark's the most analytical.
Yes. Oh, he'll drive you crazy.
He's trying to solve the world's problems through quotients and equations.
He never gets very mad about things.
That's not true.
But he's one of my best friends, so I can't say anything too bad about him.
I hate the stupid cowboy hat Mark has on.
He's almost like the balance to everything musically.
I like Dwight Yoakam and Stone Temple Pilots. I'd like to start a band someday called Stone Temple Yoakam.
Every time we do a sound check, Mark's got to get up there and put his cowboy hat on and sing some country song.
Can you get all the people in the background?
Yep.
It's all my cousins over there.
We'll be right back.
does probably the most physical manual labor. That's why he's so skinny.
He's always been cooler than the rest of us.
I guess I've known Will for probably over 8 years now. We started in college together.
I don't know, he's got this thing. I think he wants to be a sound man or something. I don't know.
He works harder than anybody I know, really.
I don't know if he knows it even, but he has become an incredible bass player.
This one you need to watch.
Some kids used to call our house and go, is his name Will or is it Bill? We just call him Will Bill.
If he wasn't in a band, I know he would be somehow trying to reach kids.
Yeah, he'll do it. He'd drive 100 miles to come pick you up somewhere if your car's broke down, or just things like that, you know.
But Bill's got a great heart, too. He's the one guy that definitely has a big heart for young people.
I always think of Bill as someone who is the perfect example of the scripture that says, walk by faith and not by sight.
He's very, has a big heart, has a very, very big heart. Very loving and caring.
I can literally say that every song he puts 110% into it.
You know, I know he'd do anything for me, and sometimes I treat him bad. And if you're watching this, Bill, I just want to say I'm sorry.
Barry Speedy Blair.
He taught Bill how to play bass like 7 or 8 years ago.
Barry's the musician in the band. He went to school, you know, he's a music major, he's a technician, very knowledgeable.
He is like the baddest guitar player in the world.
I'd say Barry, Barry's conservative and shy. Get him on stage, he turns into some kind of animal.
Barry's job on the road is accounting. He does all the accounting. He's very articulate, very detailed.
If it wasn't for him, we would probably be in jail right now from tax evasion or something like that.
I don't know, it seems like he thinks a lot. I think he'd be a good professor someday in college.
He is a really shy guy.
He has good self-esteem, but he's just not like, you know, one to stand up in a crowd and say, let's do the polka or something, you know?
When you get to know him, he's very, very funny.
He made him turn his hat around.
Ball security made me turn my hat around like this. They thought I was in a gang.
Barry was my roommate for 3 years in college, so we know each other pretty well.
Barry's the kind of guy that is always reading devotionals or the Bible or C.S. Lewis or...
Well, what do you read, Bill?
Bill
reads Mad Magazine.
Introduce PDA video to everybody.
What?
This is the PDA video.
Yeah. The one where we had the funny looking clothes on.
This is the one where they dressed us.
Talk about what happened during PDA.
Check out these overalls.
They dressed us and they posed us and put our clothes on us and yeah, it's dressed us and
they made us look like little dweebs maybe.
A mistletoe, they think it's too long that they show what they need to make convey is the love of God today. That's what they need to make display. A PDA. Show your brother, show your sister, show your mother that Jesus really loves her. No side effects or complications, no lonely times or long vacations. Go with God, no hesitation.
matter. Everything but loss. Display your love, no matter the cost. Give it yourself to save the lost. Don't get caught in a bad display. Show the love of Christ in a righteous way. You know what it is, so you have to say P-E-A. So P. Display on the fashion.
This is a truck. It's blue, and we ride back here. It's in the back is all of our stuff.
One time we went through Brooklyn, and the roads were real bad, and it was like this.
This is what it's like going from place to place. If you ever seen the movie Planes, Trains, and Automobiles, that's what we feel like sometimes.
90% of being in a band is traveling. So if you don't like to travel, don't get in a band.
Well, if you want to know what I like most and what I like least about being on the road, what I like most is coming home, and what I like least is leaving. It's supposed to be a joke. Gotta go.
Right.
You take the last Mountain Dew.
Yeah, I sure did, buddy. I'll never get the last one.
Brian Hayes is our drummer. He's been with us since February. We feel really blessed to have Brian with us. He's a great drummer. Brian's a great asset to the band, great guy.
Brian's a great driver. In fact, Brian taught me how to drive.
I'll sign off. This is me, Brian.
Just to let you know what goes on about 1 o'clock during showtime, we're usually never running around too much because there's a lot of work to do, and we always, not all the time, but usually have to help out some. Like Bill helps out a whole lot. He's like putting together a new monitor rack. Everybody pitches in together. The drivers are still asleep, like you saw Bob and Brian driving all night last night. So they're still asleep while everybody else pitches in to get the show ready. We're gonna just take a quick look at the crew here today. That's Drew right there, Drew Baca. Probably the hardest working dude in show business.
I kind of help out the guys. I used to do a lot of driving. I now do their lights and put the stage together with Bill and whoever our sound guy is at the time.
He's got a brother named Al Baca.
Hi, everybody out there in TV Land. My name is Al with Audio Adrenaline here.
We wish they had some more brothers.
Anyway, let's see what I like about the road. Absolutely nothing. Say it again.
We did a crusade in
North Carolina.
And
I had a shirt on the other day.
Was a choir loft with probably 600 gray-haired people.
Real old big choir. Like,
old. And then we did Happy You Know It, Bang Your Head, and all of them did it with us.
Well, I was in the lobby sitting there waiting.
Is that the truck? Well, no one else was there. I figured we'd sit in the lobby.
You should have got your bags in the truck and been ready. You can't just sit out in the lobby with your bags and saying, here I am, I'm here.
What I like most about being on the road is the feeling of just a bunch of guys out trying to get something done, and the fact that we're like a team, and I think that's a cool thing. I have a lot of fun. You know, it feels like we're trying to accomplish something together, and I think it's pretty cool.
This is our usual size show, we usually do. The other things were charity things we did for a friend. You know, you play these things so often, you just get a little bored.
Well, it's 2:10 in the morning, time for a haircut.
Man, we had an awesome hotel, and we slept in it for 2 hours.
crazy.
I found out I got Bob's ticket.
He thinks he's lost it.
Bob's out there running around because he thinks he lost his ticket. All he has is a ticket from last week's flight, TWA flight. We're on some other.
There he is.
Flight.
Look at Bob.
You don't have much ticket, dude. I'd like to invite Captain Rose 10.
It's anybody else's pick it up. Rose 10 through 21. It's anybody else's pick it up by accident.
Bob never loses anything.
Show the lady up there.
Bob, let's go through all the important papers that you've lost in your career.
Hey, seriously, if he doesn't find it, he's got to buy a new one. So.
No way, they won't just look in the computer and see that they have
no.
Your kid.
Did anybody check with them?
Go on and see if Bill's got it.
Bill's Bill, right I'm right here.
Brian's got it.
I'll go check. I'll go check.
Approach the podium at VA, please. Maybe I better go check, too.
Okay.
Tell about how many applications you lost trying to get your passport to go to Poland.
Oh, yeah.
And what happened? Someone snagged that.
We did 6 shows in Poland, and over 900 kids, or around 900 kids and adults came to know the Lord over there. They're really hungry for the gospel in that country, and it was amazing.
All right, we'll come down to Scott Brickle. He is our manager. Our management is True Artist Management. Scott's a great guy. Scott's a hard worker. That's the good thing about him. He works hard.
Hi, we're on America West Flight 412 from Sacramento to Phoenix. We've had the pleasure of having our favorite passengers on board, Audio Adrenaline. Be sure to watch their next video. It's our favorite, Big House.
Lots of room, a big, big table with lots and lots of food, a big, big yard where we can play football, a big, big house. It's my father's house, a big, big house with lots and lots of room, a big.
It's my father's house.
Probably the most affecting or the most powerful story anyone's ever told us about the song is there was a youth group in Oklahoma, and there was a young guy in the youth group that was really into drugs and into some bad stuff, and he was actually affecting the youth group in a negative way, actually selling drugs to some of the kids in the youth group on the bus going to a youth event, stuff like that. So over the course of a few months or a little less than a year, the kid became a Christian and started to affect the kids. And he was probably like a natural born leader or something like that. And he was really good at leading them. So he started affecting them in a positive way. And, you know, the youth group was really excited. And you know, something like that happens to a youth group, it really turns the whole group around. You know, they see a kid come in and get changed. It gives them, you know, a motivation. They think that they're doing something, which they are. After he had become a Christian, what had happened, this youth group came to one of our concerts. We were on tour with DC Talk and the Free At Last tour when we went through Oklahoma, and he was there at the tour, and the youth group was, you know, fired up and wanting to make a difference. And right after the concert, the kid was killed in an automobile accident, and the youth group really didn't know how to take it. They were in shock because, you know, less than a year ago, this kid, this hellion or whatever, became a Christian and was just doing great things for God. And then, like that, you know, he was taken away from him. It's pretty devastating. It makes you realize that life is very fragile. Sometimes you think that you're, you know, going to live forever as a young man. You think that, you know, you're indestructible. In reality, life is just, you know, so short compared to eternity. What happened, they were at the funeral, And the kids still didn't really feel peace about it, and you know, everybody was pretty sad. And then they were at the cemetery, and they'd actually placed the casket in the ground, and then the youth group was huddled out in the middle of the cemetery in a small group. And no one was really saying anything. They were just didn't have anything to talk about or speechless. And one girl started to sing the chorus of Big House. She's like, "Come and go with me to my father's house," and then more and more people started to join in, and then they sang the chorus, you know, "It's a big, big house," and they said a peace came over them. You know, God's spirit really worked on them that day and showed them that it's really not, you know, life here is just an instant, and what we're working for and what we're planning for and what we're dreaming about is life forever in the big house.
Till I lay rest, I have put myself through this rigid test. But the mile has never ended, no distance has been gained. I do not see greatness I wanted to attain. Where is my embrace from the race that I have run? I've kept a steady pace, but still no fear, I love you perfectly. Love drives our fear. I'll take your burden, you take my grace. Rest easy in my embrace. I am such a sinner, I fear my evil ways. I fear my imperfection, I fear my final days. I just want to take control, snap this rusty chain, drop my heavy burdens, it seems to be in vain. Rest easy, I have no fear, I love you perfectly. Love drives out fear. I'll take your burden.
forsake my grace. Rest easy in my just a dreamer with a timid history, scared of confrontations. I fume all through the night. The world has its hold on me, and I just wanna fly. The sky. Step aside, rest easy, high.